nos invitaron a entrevistar a Jeremy Scott para su nueva colección. Estamos súper contentas.
Vean, esto es un poquito de lo que se va a ver ahorita.
Can you describe your MAC collaboration in three words?
Fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I wanted to make colors that were fun and vibrant, like the designs I do, and have something for a kind of every different kind of personality and skin type, and kind of just kind of have something that's a little bit of something for everyone, as well as some things that maybe you haven't tried before, so that you would maybe get some of your favorite colors, but then have some new ones that you might experiment with because they are here around.
Okay.
Yeah, and I wanted also the packaging to be fun and exciting, and I obviously was very inspired by music and thought about the boombox and the cassette tape and the CD.
And why was music your inspiration for this collaboration?
Honestly, music's such a big part of everything I do in design because it's part of the soundtrack of our lives, you know. I mean, I'm always hearing music when I'm designing for so many musicians, and the music that they play, wearing my clothes, is part of pop culture. And so for me, it's just such a natural progression. Music really also is part of my shows because it's explaining the story of the mood of the season. So I love music. I love how it can transform a room. An empty room can be so different when you play music, and depending on what the music is and the way it lifts your spirit, it makes you feel.
Can you tell us your favorite story while creating this collection with MAC?
My favorite time was really just playing with the colors and mixing the colors and being able to kind of sometimes like heighten the color and kind of like taking different tones to try to make it a specific, you know, orange, or trying to get the capture of the right blue, and you know, that was really fun because it was like finger painting in a way.
What's like a cool part about your job?
Cool part about my job, I get to be part of people's lives. I mean, I love that my work is part of people's lives. People wear my clothes, and people create memories wearing the designs that I've designed, and I love being part of people's lives in that way. It's kind of magical. Maybe you're wearing something that I designed the night you were out dancing at a club, and you met your boyfriend who then becomes your future husband, and you know, then maybe you guys have a baby and you put him in a Jeremy Scott stroller, and then your baby picture is that, and then that baby grows up and it's like, look at my baby pictures, and like, that's a rad stroller, you know, and then somehow I've been a part of your lives.
And what's the hardest part of your job?
Hardest part of my job is probably the deadlines, which everyone has them, but you know, it's the speed of it and trying to constantly be sure that I'm creating and giving 100% of myself and kind of making, you know, the work as magical and special and unique each time as I would want it to be, because you know, I just run out of time. So at certain points, like, I want to do more each time.
Deadlines are terrible. It's true. So, if you could party with like anyone in the planet, who could it be?
Is this dead or alive?
Dead or alive.
I mean, I would love to have met Andy Warhol.
I told her that. Like, imagine, like, we were like planning to reach out to you. We were like creating the presents, and I was like, maybe we should add the dead thing, because maybe the answer like Andy Warhol or something like that.
I'd love to know what he was like. I would have loved to have met Marilyn Monroe and understood this magical quality that she had, that she was able to turn it off and on. And, you know, I mean, I've been spoiled to have known and worked with and be friends with so many amazing not only musicians, but celebrities in all different ways, let's say. And, you know, but there's always the people that you never would have had the opportunity to, that you would love to be able to know and meet and kind of experience.
What do you consider your greatest achievement?
Well, I mean, in one way, personally, it was last year. I celebrated my 20-year anniversary of having my own line and being independent. And that's kind of a big deal, I think, you know, for doing challenging fashion like I do, and to be able to continue to do it on my own terms and create a new name for today, because, you know, I think that's important for, say, the youth to see, like, hey, you know, I can too. You have a dream, you have a vision, you have determination, you have drive, and you have a passion, that you can too make a name for yourself on your own.
Yeah.
And it doesn't have to only be, let's say, with you know, established houses. I mean, yes, now I also have a second role as the creative director of Moschino, but, you know, I've created my own brand, my own identity, and had, you know, created my own fan base through my work, and I think that's something that...
And very, your own name.
Yes, and I'm very... Thank you, and I'm very proud of that, and having the moment to stop at the 20-year anniversary and kind of reflect really made me think about that and appreciate it more and think about not only is that important, like I said, to me, but hopefully important to other people, because yeah. It should, whether it's even you doing design or if it's about you doing your work, that like, hey, you know, he did, I can do that. And it gives you a positive hope yeah. in that way.
Is there something right now in life that has you like excited?
I mean, obviously I'm just really excited to be here at Mexico yeah. City right now and to get to experience that, because it's one of the joys of my work is getting to travel and go places that I normally wouldn't be, you know, and so I get to see people, meet new people, and share my work with people. So.
Is it your first time in Mexico?
No, it's my, no, I've been to Mexico several times, but it's my third time in Mexico City.
Okay.
Been to Tulum, been to Cancun.
Nice. Yeah. Tulum is the best.
Yeah, it's beautiful, super magic. Yeah.
If you have one advice for someone who wants to work in fashion, what yeah. would it be?
It's follow your heart, honestly. You're always gonna find your happiness and your passion following your truth, and when you're doing what you love and what you feel good, that's where your success is going to come from. And you know, there's so many different things in fashion, there's so many aspects, from design to style to journalism to PR to, you know, there's all these intricate things. So, you know, go intern, be part of it, try to, you know, be a part of anything that you can of it, and then you'll see kind of maybe where you fit right. You know, you're like, oh, actually, I love this. I thought I wanted to be that because that's what I understood and that was visual. You know, kind of an example, but maybe I actually found my niche here, you know, and I think that that's the thing to do, is you try to volunteer, intern, be a part of it, go to events, help friends of yours, whatever it is, so that you're kind of like, you know, embedded in it, and then you'll kind of feel where you're right.
Be there.
Yeah, 100%. Exactly. Yeah. No, nothing better than experience yeah. by doing, you know.